Hello students, welcome back to the class of Basics of Electrical Engineering. It's Unit 5 DC Circuit. This will be the third lecture based on this Unit 5 DC Circuit. Up till now we have covered the syllabus up to Kirchhoff's laws. What is remaining in this Unit 5? Superposition theorem and Thevenin's theorem and numerical based on both. So under the lecture 3, we will cover superposition theorem and numerical, Thevenin's theorem and numerical based on that. What is superposition theorem? What is the statement of that? In any multi-source complex network consisting of linear bilateral element, the voltage across or current through any branch of network is equal to the algebraic sum of individual voltage or current, which is produced independently by each source acting alone. When all the other independent ideal voltage source replaced by short circuit and all other independent current sources replaced by open circuit. The non-ideal sources are replaced by their internal resistance. What does it mean? What is the explanation? Step 1. Consider the given circuit. How many voltages are there? There are two voltages, V1 and V2. With the internal resistance RI1 and RI2 respectively. Let us find out the current flowing through the resistance connected between the terminal A and B, that is R3. With the help of superposition theorem. What is the step 2? According to the statement, we have to consider only one source at a time. In the given network, there were two sources. Because of two sources, the current flowing through the resistance is, say, I3. But according to superposition theorem, we have to find out current flowing through the resistance because of only one source. Considering the voltage source V1 acting alone in the circuit and the remaining sources V2, we have to replace it by its internal resistance. Say the internal resistance of V2 is RI2. We have to put this internal resistance if it is given. But most of the time, or we can say all the times, the internal resistance is not given. So we have to simply short circuit the given voltage. Are you getting this? Now by using the Kirchhoff's law or by any method, by network simplification method, by series parallel method, current division rule, you can apply any method to find out the current flowing through the resistance R3. Let us assume that the current flowing through the resistance R3 because of voltage source V1 is I1 dash, which is flowing from A to B, that is from top to bottom. Now under the step 3, now consider the another source. What is the another source? It is V2 acting alone in the circuit, and the remaining sources we have to replace it by its internal resistance. Therefore, we will replace this V1 by its internal resistance RI1 if it is given. If not given, we have to simply short circuit it. If it is voltage source, short circuit it. If it is current source, open circuit it. Most of the time, the given circuit is of voltage source. But if it is a current source, we have to open circuit it. Now let us assume that under this situation, the current in R3 is I1 double dash. Because of the voltage source V2, I1 double dash is the current flowing through the resistance R3. And which is flowing from the V2A point, that is bottom to top. The direction of current plays an important role. So under this step 4, hence the net current flowing through the resistance R3 in the circuit will be I1 dash plus I2 dash for both the current in the same direction. but we have assumed that for our network the direction of current I1 dash and current I2 dash was different. Therefore, here it will be I1 double dash minus I1 dash. If they are in same direction, take the addition. If they are in different direction, take the subtraction. This is how we can calculate current flowing through any network with the help of this superposition theorem. There will be number of voltage sources and current sources in the circuit. We have to consider only one energy source at a time, and we have to calculate current flowing through any resistance with the help of superposition theorem. Back to the statement. What the statement says? Any multi-source complex network. Multi-source means what? There will be multi. Multi means many sources, and it is a complex network. It is a hard network consisting of linear bilateral element. Linear lateral means what? Linear network means what? Resistance is a linear element. Resistance is a linear element. What is bilateral means? Bilateral means which works in both the direction. Again, the resistance is bilateral element. The voltage across or current through any branch in the network is equal to algebraic sum of individual voltage or current produced independently by each source acting alone. Means in the given multi-source complex network, which is consisting of linear bilateral element, we can find out voltage across or current through any branch of the network. By how? By taking the algebraic sum of individual voltage and current produced independently by each source acting alone. If there are two sources, we have to consider only one source at a time. Find out current or voltage. In the second step, consider the second source and short circuit the first source if it is a voltage source. Open circuit the first source if it is a current source. Then find out current through the same branch. And then find out the total current or the total voltage across that branch of interest. Okay. What else is given? When all the independent ideal voltage source are replaced by short circuit. When the given voltage source is ideal voltage source, we have to short circuit it, and all the independent current source are replaced by open circuit. If it is voltage source, short circuit. If it is current source, open circuit it. If it is non-ideal one, what we need to do? We have to replace the voltage source or current source by their internal resistance. If it is a non-ideal voltage source, we have to replace by the resistance, internal resistance of voltage source, which should be connected in series with that voltage source. If it is a current source, non-ideal current source, we have to replace that current source by parallel resistance. In the second lecture, in the first lecture itself, I have explained about the energy sources, ideal voltage source, practical voltage source, ideal current source and practical current source. Okay. So this is how we have to apply this superposition theorem. Say there are two voltage sources V1 and V2, and the three resistances are there, R1, R2 and R3. We need to find out resistance flowing through the resistance R1 with the help of superposition theorem. What superposition theorem says? It is a complex network having more than one circuit element. So to find out the current flowing through the resistance R1, we have to consider only one voltage source at a time. Considering V1 only acting alone in the circuit, and V2 we have to replace it by its internal resistance. If internal resistance is not given, we have to short circuit that voltage source V2. And then by any method we have to find out current flowing through the resistance R1. Okay, in the next step we have to find out again current flowing through the resistance R1, now because of the voltage source V2 only. And replace V1 by short circuiting. Calculate current flowing through I1, say this is I2, by any method, current division rule or KVL or something. So the total current flowing through the resistance R1 will be the addition of I1 plus I2. I1 is the current because of the voltage source V1, and I2 is the current because of voltage source V2. This is what superposition theorem. Redundant branch and combination. While solving the numerical, you may come up across the redundant branch. What is redundant branch? The branch which do not carry a current in a network are said to be redundant branch. can see here in the shown network. This is the branch which is having no circuit elements, means the resistance of this circuit element is zero. So this is a voltage source which is delivering I current. Where this I current will flow? The entire I current will flow through this redundant branch. Whereas this resistance is connected in parallel with this redundant branch, but because of this redundant branch, no current will flow through this resistance branch. Since current always try to flow through the least resistance path. This is similar to there are two roads. One road is trafficated and another road is completely empty. So which you will use? Obviously where there is no traffic. Similarly, the current will travel through the least resistance path. So in this case, we have to open circuit this resistance. We have to cut this resistance from the circuit because of this redundant branch. Let us see one more example. In this shown circuit, the resistance R3 is parallel with this link. The resistance R3 is parallel with this link. Let I current is flowing through this network. R1, R2, these are in series. So here I current. Because of this redundant branch, no current will flow through this resistance. Therefore, we have to open circuit this resistance. The entire current will flow through this path because there is no resistance in this branch. Therefore, entire current will flow through this. So this branch is called as the redundant branch. The R3 branch is called as the redundant branch, which do not carry a current in the network. Similarly, in this PQ, there are two resistances, R3 and R4. This R3 and R4 is parallel with this link, and this parallel link is having no opposition, no resistance. Resistance is zero, therefore the entire current coming from this R2 will flow through this link only, and no current will flow through this combination R3 and R4. Therefore this branch PQ is also called as redundant branch. We have to remove this branch from the circuit while solving the numericals. Let us solve one more numerical based on the superposition theorem. We have to calculate current flowing through 8 ohm resistance for the shown circuit by applying superposition theorem. How many voltage sources are there? There are two voltage sources, 250 volts and 75 volts. And there are four resistances. We have to find out current flowing through this 8 ohm resistance. We have to consider only one voltage source at a time and replace the another voltage source by short circuit since the internal resistance is not given. Then we have to find out current flowing through the resistance 8. By any method, by KVL or by current division rule. In the next step, we have to find out again current flowing through 8 because of second voltage source and by replacing the first voltage source by short circuiting it. Let us solve it. Step 1. Consider only 250 voltage source acting alone and short circuit this V2. Here there was V2. We have to short circuit this V2. Okay. Now, we have to find out current flowing through this 8 ohm resistance. Firstly, we will simplify this network. See, the 8 ohm resistance is in parallel with this 10 ohm resistance. They are in series. For series combination, we have to add this. So, the entire resistance will be 18 ohm. Now, what we can see, this 18 ohm is in parallel with this 5 ohm. By solving this, we are getting 3.91 ohm. Now this 3.91 ohm is in series with this 5 ohm. Just add it. Therefore the total resistance of this network is 8.91. Say the current delivering by this 250 voltage source is I1. According to Ohm's law, I1 is equal to voltage divided by resistor. The voltage, total voltage is 250, the total resistance is 8.91. Therefore the current delivering by the 250 voltage source is 28.06 amperes. We have to find out current flowing through the resistance 8 ohms. How to calculate this? I have explained you the current division rule. Okay, what is current division rule? We have to find out current in this branch. Say this current is I2 dash. Therefore, I2 dash is equal to total current is I1, which is 28.06 into opposite resistor of this branch, the opposite resistors connected in parallel is of 5 ohm, divided by addition of both the resistances connected in parallel. This is addition of these two is 18, 18 is parallel with 5, therefore 18 plus 5. Therefore, current flowing through 8 ohm resistance is 6.10 ampere with the direction from top to bottom. Similarly, we have to find out current flowing through 8 ohm resistance because of this second voltage source, that is 75 volts. By replacing the remaining voltage sources by short circuit and the remaining current sources by open circuit if the internal resistance is not given. Okay. Now first we will simplify this network. You can see here the 5 ohm resistances, these two resistances are connected in parallel. How to solve? 5 into 5 divided by 5 plus 5 is equal to 2.5 ohms. The total resistance of the circuit is equal to this 2.5 plus this 10 plus this 8. They are in series, therefore adding. Therefore the total resistance will be 20.5 ohms. Therefore I2, current delivered because of this 75 volt, is equal to voltage divided by resistance. This is 3.66 amperes. We have assumed the direction of current from this positive terminal to negative terminal. Therefore, direction is from B to A. This is current flowing through this 8 ohm resistor. It is I2. Now, we have to add both the current because of V1 plus current because of V2 in the step 3. Therefore, the entire current flowing through the 8 ohm resistor is I by considering the polarity of the current. Because of the 250 volt, the current is I1 dash with the downward polarity, and because of the second voltage source 75 volts, the current is flowing from bottom to top. When the polarity of both the current is different, we have to take the subtraction. When the polarity of both the current is in same direction, we have to take the addition. Therefore, taking the subtraction, we are getting answer 2.44 amperes with downward direction. This is all about the superposition theorem. Okay. Next theorem is Thevenin's theorem. What is Thevenin's theorem? An active complex network having two terminals A and B. An active complex network having terminals A and B can be replaced by a constant voltage source having an EMF VTH and the internal resistance RTH. The value of VTH is equal to open circuit potential drop between the terminals A and B, whereas the RTH is the resistance of the network measured between the terminal A and B with the load disconnected and the source EMF replaced by its internal resistance. In simple words, I can say this complex network we have to reduce to Thevenin's equivalent circuit. There might be number of voltage source, number of resistances connected in series. We have to reduce this number of voltage source into only one voltage source called as the Thevenin's voltage. And the number of resistances we have to reduce to only one resistance called as the Thevenin's resistance. Now how to reduce the number of voltage source into only one voltage source? How we can do it? There are steps to solve this. Let us explain one by one. And then at the last we have to find out current flowing through this resistance, load resistance RL. According to Ohm's law, this current is equal to voltage divided by total resistance. The voltage is VTH and the resistance is the total RTH plus the resistance RL. At the last, if it is asked, we have to find out current flowing through the resistance. What are the steps to apply to Thevenin's theorem? Step 1. We have to remove the branch resistance through which current is to be calculated. Simply we have to remove it. In the second step, we have to calculate voltage across this open circuited terminal by using any of network simplification technique. And this voltage will be Thevenin's voltage. In the next step, we have to calculate the R equivalent as weaved through the two terminal of branch voltage source by short circuit and current source by open circuit. In the next step, draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit showing the voltage source VTH with the resistance R equivalent in series with it. This R equivalent is nothing but RTH, Thevenin's resistance, and then across the terminal of branch of interest. In the last step, we have to reconnect the branch resistance, that is RL, and the required current through the branch is given by Ohm's law. I is equal to VTH divided by RTH plus RL. Let us solve one numerical based on this Thevenin's theorem. We are using the same network as we have solved by using superposition theorem. We have to find out again current flowing through this 8 ohm resistance. But here we have to use Thevenin's theorem. Let us apply the steps. Firstly, we have to remove the load resistance. The resistance connected between the terminal or the branch of interest of terminal, we have to open circuit it. Then by any method we have to calculate current flowing through this. How to calculate it? By applying KVL. See, since this is open circuited, no current will flow through this 10 ohm resistance. Okay, therefore there will be only one loop. By applying KVL to this loop, what we are getting? We are getting I amperes of current is equal to 25. I is the current flowing through this 5 ohm resistance. In the next step, we have to find out VTH. In the next step, we have to find out VTH. VTH is the open circuit voltage between the branch of interest. Now, to find out VTH, we have to apply KVL to this second loop. After applying KVL to this second loop, what we are getting? See, we have to first mark the polarity of resistances. When we are tracing in a clockwise direction, while tracing from this to this point, this terminal will be positive with respect to this terminal. Don't change the polarity of this given EMF. This will remain same. When the current is flowing from bottom to top, this will be the plus polarity and this will be the negative polarity. Now trace it in any direction will give you VTH is equal to 50 volts. Now we have to find out RTH. How to find out RTH? Again, keep the terminal or branch of interest open circuited and short circuit all the voltage sources. We have to short circuit this voltage source as well. Then there will be three resistances, 5 ohm, 5 ohm and 10 ohm. This 5 and 5 is in parallel and this combination is in series with this 10 ohm resistance. 5 and 5 will give you 2.5 plus 10 will give you the total resistance 12.5 ohm. This is called as Thevenin's resistance. Now convert the given network into Thevenin's equivalent network, where VTH is equal to 50 volts and RTH is equal to 12.5 ohms. To calculate current flowing through this RL, again reconnecting this load resistance between the terminal A and B. Now apply Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, current through this AB IL is equal to what? Voltage divided by total resistance. The voltage is VTH and the total resistance is RTH plus RL. So 50 divided by 12.5 plus 8 gives you 2.44. The current is same as we have obtained using superposition theorem. Using any method, superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem or by Kirchhoff's law, the answer will be same. Only the method is different. This is all about the superposition theorem and Thevenin's theorem. You should do more and more practice for solving the numerical based on superposition theorem and Thevenin's theorem. The solved numericals will be given to you. Do more practice. All the best. Thank you.